I'm going to show you how to make the buffalo plaid. Don't you find that you love the print, but you want a different colour? Nowhere can you find the colour. You see, I like a bit of sparkle. So that's why I decided to work a plan on how to make the buffalo print manually. Welcome, my name's Louise, and before we start, remember to subscribe and like if you want to see more videos like this. First tip, I find that if I'm printing a whole lot of different pictures, I load them on the software and cut them all together. This saves money and time. So if I've got black, I will cut a whole lot of different blacks, then reds, then greens, or glitters, or whatever. Now I'm showing you in the basic colors because the shine does affect the camera. So first, cut the black. If your eyes are not great like mine, change the color around. It makes it much easier to piddle a red or a green or whatever. But if you are using sparkly, do not. Just cut it with the black. When cutting the buffalo print, put a bit more pressure on the knife, i.e. cut deeper. It just means it's easier to piddle. So when you're weeding this, make sure that you cut it into smaller pieces. As you can see here, I've taken the big bit off. Now cut it in half there because the tree's one side and the other. And this time you pull it very carefully. Don't rush this part. It's not worth it. So, and use a pin. I always find a pin is very helpful. I did have a piece of wood with a very sharp point on the end, but I've misplaced it, so I use a pin. When finishing weeding, the tip I find is to put it over a white piece of paper to check if I've done all the weeding, which I did not do here. So I left a few bits in. Only when filming did I notice. But be patient, and it's not as difficult as you think it's going to be. But always have a good pin with you. I always test my designs before I publish them on Etsy. I believe that it needs to be right before it's published. So if you do buy any of my designs and you do find you have a problem, please let me know so I can sort out the problem straight away. If you're wanting these designs, I have put a link below. There is 5 designs in one. These designs are great for bags and for cards, so you don't have to make more stickers for there. I've made them this weekend, and already 2 friends have bought 10 each. And I've only just started making them. So I reckon this Christmas they're a good money maker. If you think you're making a market, doing a market store, these would be a good little seller. And also they'll be handy because if you don't sell them, you can use them. Once you've finished weeding the black, do the different colors now and get them ready. When first doing this design, I would suggest using the simple design, like this one. First, press your basic color. Now, what I do is, I put the colored vinyl, or whichever the solid, underneath the design that I want, so that I can get the placement right. So, as you can see, I've done the red. Now, I'm putting the green with the black on top, and I'm lining that up, not 2 sticky sides together, otherwise you'll lose bits. But if you notice, I'm lining it up very carefully so that I know I've got the alignment right. Then I stick it onto the garment that I'm wanting it on. Once both pieces are pressed on, I've cut the star off because it's black, and black on black doesn't show. So now I'm lining it up as close as I possibly can. This is a little bit of a fiddle, just making sure that you've got it right. And line it up very carefully. Once it's lined up, then press on. And there you are. You have now got buffalo print. Now I put the sparkle on and the gold and make sure that it's looking nice. Got to have a bit of sparkle for Christmas. Press everything else that you want on the design. I have made the Merry Christmases separate so that if you just want to print Merry Christmas on its own, you can. There is some samples here of bags that I've done. Now, if you like the video, don't forget to subscribe. I'm also going to be covering how to design on computer. Also, my files are great for sublimation. Okay, take care. Bye. Happy crafting.